What's up, guys? Today we're doing TIG plus stick. Weekend training for a subscriber. The guy training today is a 15-year vet in power plants and refineries. He's been hitting me up for years to learn pipe stick. So as soon as I got the rig set up, I told him to get his ass over here. Let's check out his hot pass first. Draking it nicely with high amps. Him, rip pass looks solid. Amps were on point. And he laid it down real pretty. You can tell he's got field experience, nice wide bead. This is schedule 80 pipe. We're gonna switch to stick from here. Stick welding gets way harder on thinner pipes. First off, you gotta master the backstep technique. We're running a 7016 rod low hydrogen. The biggest mistake rookies make is porosity right at the start. See that graphite tip on the rod? That helps strike the arc. Drag it down about an inch 30 millimeters as you start. Once the arc stabilizes, separate the puddle from the slag and burn right back over that inch you just dragged. The machine we're using today is a top-tier Korean welder used in power plants. It's optimized for TIG and stick combo. Real field equipment. Let's do some vertical welding. Lower your body as you burn the rod. I'm gonna move in fast. Find your comfortable stance. Use both hands for support ... and start. Drag down an inch. Alright, knock off that first slag. The key at the start is separating that first glob of slag from the metal. If you mess this part up, you get massive porosity at the start. That's a critical defect. And it's the most common rookie mistake. Next is tight arc length. Keep that distance consistent. Master these two and your foundation is set. See, the bead came out super clean. This CNG welder runs smooth as butter. It burns rod perfectly even at low amps. Now, if you're doing overhead and trying to control amps, with one hand, that's brutally hard. For beginners, damn near impossible. Crank the amps up and the puddle drips on you. That's why this machine has a hot start function. Hot start blasts high current right at the beginning. Set at 100, it kicks off at 150. Stabilizes the arc fast and pushes that slag out. Now our subscribers gonna try with hot start. Drag it down an inch and go. People think hot start is only for plate welding. But for RT X-ray pipe welding, it's a game changer. Use the tech available to you, it helps your skills. He tied into my weld, let's check it out. man, that is excellent work. He self-taught for a year, pretty impressive. Let's burn a few more rods. He's getting a taste of that hot start power. His job site still uses ancient machines. His basics are solid, let's chip the slag. Watch out for the concave spots on the edges. Fix those little habits and he's ready for overhead. What do you do when the pipe is low? Use your knee as a prop and grab the rod with two hands. Then execute the backstab. Here is the most important part. Generic welders sold at the hardware store. They can't melt the rod properly in overhead. Especially for millimeters rods, low amp control is impossible. The rod doesn't burn right. So the slag and puddle don't separate. Most of those machines are just glorified flat welders. You wonder why the rod sticks and why the slag sticks. Practicing without knowing that? You can practice forever and go nowhere. Choosing the right machine is critical. Power plants use Daiho, CNG, Isuzu. These are the main players. There's a reason pros use these. When you're doing overheader, the difference against a cheap welder is night and day. Especially on 9-crumb pipe, you need that low amp control. But with those generic boxes, if you try overhead, the rod won't burn and sticks to the pipe. But if you crank the amps up, half sticks, half drips, and it turns into a total shout. You think all modern welders are the same? For flat plate, maybe. But for pro pipe welding, huge difference. I ain't advertising for them. I'm just giving credit where it's due. If you're self-taught on stick, do yourself a favor and get a Daiho, Isuzu, or CNG. Back to our subscriber. He practiced for a year at home and work. He said he never knew rods could burn this smooth and overhead before. We'll be doing weekend training here from now on. We're prepping for 20-inch big bore pipe training too. If you're desperate to learn stick, this is gonna help a lot. Flat and flush, no bumps, nice weld. He's ready for the cap pass. Catch you guys in the next video for the cap. Thanks for watching.